Today I've been doing a bit of writing about a concept called toughness, and that's part of the trifecta that I talk about of essential skills that you need if you're running a business, which is to be organized, be tough, and be competent. So I've put a little list together of the things that I think are important when it comes to being tough, and I'm talking mental toughness, internal toughness, as opposed to, you know, being brutal and you know, forcing people to bend to your will, as it were. So the first one for me is that you need to have the ability to work hard and to respond strongly when things don't go right. You know, when you get a bit of a failure or some adversity, that you know how to handle that. Then the next thing is to make sure that you're able to stick to your long-term passions and goals, and you don't get buffeted by the side winds, as it were, while you are trying to achieve those, and that you don't give up and achieve something that is a lesser outcome that will cause you to feel regret, because there's nothing more futile than regret. So the ability to complete what you start, as far as I'm concerned, that is a real hallmark of toughness. Just make sure that what you decided that you're going to complete is actually realistic and within your capability, and you're not setting yourself up for failure. And another really important one is the ability to change your mind when the evidence to do so is compelling. And that actually requires a lot of toughness, because you've invested a lot in getting to where you're getting to, and all of a sudden you have to come to the realization that this isn't the right way. And it can be fairly upsetting. And, you know, the inclination at that point is to say, oh, bugger it, I'll just give up. But actually, the tough people then go and figure out the right way to do it. And remember that very, very old prayer to have the courage to change the things that you can change, the humility to accept the things you can't change, and the wisdom to know the difference. And that's what we're talking about. It's that wisdom to know the difference and then know when to change and so on. So another one for me is the ability to stay on track when a supposedly easier and maybe questionable option is presented. Look, there are no shortcuts. There are no shortcuts to setting up a great business. You have to do the things that you have to do. And the only thing that shortcuts are, as far as I'm concerned, they're short-term solutions, but they frequently lead to longer-term disasters. Another really important one that people struggle with is the ability to make people decisions, tough people decisions, early. Okay, so you need to think about the greater good. And in your case, if you own the business, the greater good is the business. And if you've got somebody in the business who's not performing or is undermining things, then you need to make those tough people calls really quickly, because there's a lot of other people whose welfare depends on you being tough in these circumstances. Now, show what I call ruthless compassion. You know, you're dealing with a person. The person's got their own feelings and so on and so forth. But the ruthlessness comes from saying, yes, I've got somebody, an individual that I'm dealing with, but the greater good, i.e. the other people in the business and my livelihood, actually outweighs that. So I will deal with them in a compassionate way, but I will get the thing done. And the last one to talk about, I think, is the ability just to keep going when you're scared, you know, overcoming the fear and doing it anyway. That wonderful book by Susan Jeffers called Feel the Fear and Do It Anyway. And a lot of people that I know who are really tough, the first thing they say is, look, I'm not just blasé about things. I get scared, but the point is that I keep going. And actually, when you're scared and you keep going, that's when you're being brave. And every organization needs a brave person in it. We'll catch you later.